Now, that was just one position. That was just, you know, this position. Every major chord shape has three positions up and down the neck, because there's three notes in an arpeggio, which makes up a chord shape, which leads us to the book, to the philosophy that we can start on three different notes of our arpeggiated sequence. So here's our cascade shape, which is our F shape on the first string bass. D shape. So that's our D shape on our first string. First string D, and then the next one's gonna be our arrow shape, which is this shape right here. Arrow shape, I called that. Do your studies on the arrow shape. I made a guitar maps right there on the front of the guitar page. I got up there for now. Otherwise, you might have to search it. Guitar colored maps, colored arpeggio maps might be the search engine if you can't find it right now. Don't forget to put dash just play man in the search so it goes right to it. Supposedly, you can try all kinds of things. So here's the arrow on the second string bass. This one's extra challenging because you're having to stretch out your winky dinky. This is the first time I've ever done this one. And then we have the recline or the C shape on the third string bass. When I say third string bass, I'm not talking about low bass note, I'm talking about foundation, where we are in the registers of the There's the fourth string bass. You know, because four strings where all the action is, the pull-offs. That's why we call it the fourth string foundation. And that's an E shape on the fourth string bass. And then C shape, third string bass, and then arrow shape, second string bass, and then D shape, first string bass. So we've covered two arpeggio notes of the major shape. Next video is going to be the third and final.